How are you doing?
Hope you're doing well. I hope you did shower as in you doing okay. Are you alright? A lot of you guys saw me post pictures of this hairstyle or me in this hairstyle on Instagram, and a lot of you guys are like, tutorial, tutorial, tutorial. And I'm like, okay, I will make a tutorial. I bought these 3 wigs from my local beauty supply store. They're synthetic wigs, so they're pretty inexpensive. I don't remember the name, like the brand and the style at the moment, because I got it like about a year ago. So provide that information in the info section below. One of the wigs, I decided, okay, let me try something new and see how it turns out. This is what I ended up with. I didn't do a tutorial because I was kind of doing like a trial and error. This is my first time having this kind of hairstyle, and turns out a lot of you guys like it and you would like to see a tutorial. I decided to attempt to remake the style with one of the other wigs of the same style that I have. The one that I'm going to be using is of a different color. This one is the black one. I actually got them in 3 different colors, but the other one I'm gonna be using has some blonde highlight. I call it like a full mushroom cut or bowl cut. This is what it looks like all around. Hope you found this tutorial helpful. This is what the style looks like naturally. And you can wear it like this too, so as long as the bang is trimmed a little bit. And you just train it to fall whichever side you want it to fall. And you have a new hairstyle. But I decided to experiment a little and ended up with the full mushroom cut. Since the hair is a little thin, it's not really enough to achieve that kind of style. So I decided to add some tracks of hair to the front. The hair that I use is this 8-inch sample Brazilian hair from Maven, but you can use whatever human hair you're able to find as long as it's able to take heat. This is a synthetic wig, but you can use heat on it, it says, so it doesn't melt. I glued it on with the hot glue gun. I got this from a local craft store, I think Joann's or something like that. The glue gun helps it stay longer rather than using like the regular hair glue. Before you put on the wig and start gluing the extension onto it, you want to make sure you wear like a shower cap or some kind of plastic on your head before you place the wig on top, because you don't want to glue your own hair. That's going to be a disaster. You don't want that. You have to be really quick when using the hot glue gun. Like, you don't want to wait for it to get tacky because it dries really quick. So once you apply it to the extension, you just go ahead and glue it. I added about 4 tracks, and now I'm just gonna go ahead and cut it. Here's the outcome of this one. The fact that the highlights are mainly concentrated on this part of the wig makes it look a little bit more unique. Hopefully you guys found this helpful. Very, very quick and easy. When cutting the bangs, I just cut like in little sections, and I cut up slowly because I don't want it to be too short. I like it to
kind of not cover my eyes, but just to sit on top of my eyes, like right there. Also like a blunt bowl cut. I'm gonna leave more information in the info section below. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll talk to you all later. Bye.